Now a story about hearts and minds. That's Purple Hearts and soldiers with traumatic brain injuries suffered in combat. Our report is an unusual public media collaboration. The NewsHour worked with our colleagues at PBS's Frontline to produce this story. It was based on the reporting of T. Christian Miller of the online reporting website ProPublica and Daniel Zwerdling of National Public Radio. He's the one with the headsets on.
I don't remember a lot anymore. I don't even remember a lot of my childhood anymore.
Michelle Dyarman was a major in the Army. We met her at the farmhouse in Pennsylvania where she grew up.
Coming here today, I got lost three times. I had to turn around and find my way three times. And I've driven that route many a time.
Dyarman was on the dean's list back in college. She got a master's. But everything changed in Iraq. 2 days before Christmas, 2005, Dyarman's platoon was coming back from a mission, and a roadside bomb exploded in front of her, like the one in the archive footage. Studies show that the blast wave shoots through metal. It shoots through soldiers' brains, and it damages the brain cells and circuits. Dyarman says it's hazy, but she remembers that she wrenched her back and neck, and she thinks the medics gave her Tylenol and Valium.
I realized I had a screaming bad headache. Take the worst headache you've ever had and multiply it by about 1,000. And I've had an ongoing headache ever since.
Michelle's father, John, doesn't know what's wrong with her.
She's not the person she was. Michelle used to do everything for me. You know, take care of all my paperwork and stuff, and I kind of help her now.
Oh, my goodness. That's all your records?
Dyarman's files tell the story. She's had to fight the Army to figure out what's wrong with her brain.
This box is heavy.
6 weeks after the explosion, the Army sent Dyarman home, but she says she could hardly function. So the Army sent her to Walter Reed Hospital. The doctors there gave her counseling for post-traumatic stress disorder and physical therapy for her neck and back, but nobody diagnosed her main injury until Dyarman left the Army. Persistent symptoms from traumatic brain injury, or TBI. Anybody at Walter Reed ever say to you, Michelle, there's something called a traumatic brain injury, and you've been in two blasts and a motor vehicle accident. Perhaps you have one. We're going to look into this.
No.
Dyarman's not alone. The Pentagon's official figures show that 115,000 troops have suffered TBIs. Some studies suggest the true number could be several times higher. Most soldiers get better within days of a TBI, but Dyarman's part of what researchers call the miserable minority. Their symptoms last for years, maybe forever. Studies suggest there could be tens of thousands of soldiers like Michelle Dyarman. But Dyarman's files show that many commanders still don't believe the TBIs are really an injury. She's applied several times for the Purple Heart, and the Army has never approved it.
So what is it about the Purple Heart that feels especially important?
It says that I was injured in combat. In a war, it's a part of history, and I can't seem to get that documented.
For soldiers like Dyarman, the Purple Heart says you faced the enemy. You sacrificed for your country. It's been awarded since the 1930s.
Purple Hearts are awarded to United States soldiers who bravely met the attacks of communist bandits and suffered heroically under fire.
The Army spells out the kinds of injuries that merit Purple Hearts, like bullet wounds, illness from poison gas, and concussion from explosions, which is the same as TBI.
The Purple Heart Award is only an indirect expression of the real appreciation of a grateful nation.
So we went to the Pentagon to find out, why hasn't the Army given Purple Hearts to many soldiers with TBI?
The Purple Heart shows that you did your job. You met with and closed with the enemy. that you went into harm's way to stand up for something your country believes in.
Peter Corelli is the second most powerful general in the Army. He's the vice chief of staff. He's the point man on health issues like TBI.
These are the guys you talk to here.
Corelli says it's true. Some commanders still don't award Purple Hearts for concussion, despite the regulations. They still don't get that TBI is really an injury. But he says he's trying to change that.
We've got to change the culture of the Army. We've got to change the culture of society to get people the help they need. But it is a long process. Just because you don't see blood, just because you don't see a bullet hole, just because you don't see a missing appendage does not mean an individual hasn't been injured.
So if I'm a soldier or a Marine, mm-hmm. and I'm in a blast, mm-hmm. and a doctor diagnoses me with having a concussion or a mild traumatic brain injury as a result of that blast, I should get the Purple Heart.
Yes, you should.
No question.
Well, you're going to have to go through a process.
And then General Corelli got into the fine print. And soldiers say that fine print makes it almost impossible for them to get the Purple Hearts they say they deserve. Take Nathan Scheller. He was a tank commander. He suffered multiple concussions in Iraq. He says at first he felt he didn't deserve a Purple Heart. Some of his buddies lost their legs. But now that he's home, Scheller realizes his brain doesn't work right anymore. His wife, Miriam, agrees.
It's a lot more to try to even get his attention. He repeats himself a lot more now that he's been home as well. In the 5 minutes he's telling a simple story, he'll tell that story 5 times. You can't see his injury, really. He looks perfectly fine. So there's even times that I, as a spouse, forget something's really going on with him.
Scheller was home from Iraq for a year before doctors diagnosed his traumatic brain injury.
So what they did was they took out the...
They sent him to a brain rehabilitation clinic. But when it comes to the Purple Heart, he has to prove what happened to him in Iraq. He has to prove he was wounded in a specific explosion on a specific day. He has to show that a doctor diagnosed his TBI and treated him. And that can be a huge problem for a lot of soldiers because Army doctors didn't keep many of those records.
I would get told that, well, I got to have this form. So I would get this form, start over. You know, the Army wants to ask you, well, how long were you knocked out for? How the hell do I know? So I prepared all this paperwork myself, and then I submitted it.
To whom?
To my commander, but it would never go any farther than this.
So what is the policy?
We ask the Army two simple questions. Which commanders rejected Purple Hearts for Scheller and other soldiers with TBI? And why? The spokesman told us they don't keep that information. But we obtained internal Army documents, and they suggest one answer. These emails show that commanders in Iraq debated whether they should give Purple Hearts to most soldiers with TBI. Some thought it was like giving the Purple Heart for minor scrapes. That mindset became official policy under General Joseph Caravallo. He ran the medical system in Iraq in 2008. His memo said in many cases, soldiers would not get Purple Hearts if they only got minimal medical treatment. The problem is, the official regulations don't say anything about how much treatment you have to get for a bullet wound or any other injury. So Caravallo's memo creates a much tougher standard for TBI. Caravallo wouldn't talk to us, but he told us in email that he was trying to help. We showed his memo to General Corelli. Were you aware of this memo before yesterday or today?
No, I wasn't. I've asked my lawyers to look at it to make sure that we have not made this more restrictive than the Army regulation, which is very...
Corelli says some soldiers with TBIs have received Purple Hearts, but the Pentagon told us they don't know how many, and they don't know how many have been denied.
And I appreciate you bringing this to my attention. I will go down range and ensure that I talk to them and let them know that they need to be more in line with the regulation.
We asked officials at the Pentagon, what's the Purple Heart policy in Afghanistan now that the fighting and explosions are shifting there? They said they're revising the policy. Meanwhile, the military says they're making progress on traumatic brain injury in general. They've just opened a center to study it, and they've rolled out new policies designed to diagnose and treat it better. But for soldiers like Michelle DeArmon, those changes haven't come fast enough. She's been fighting for proper treatment for almost 5 years.
It feels like nobody cares. Like I was left behind. And one of the things you always learn from the very beginning is never leave a soldier behind. I was left behind.
DeArmon and her family and friends say she's still struggling with her brain injury. And she's still waiting for her Purple Heart.
On our website, you can explore how the NewsHour has followed the emergence of TBI as a serious medical issue in the military, plus find links to Front Lines coverage of the subject.